Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
A'udhu billahi as-sami'i al-alim min ash-shaytanir rajim. Rabbi a'udhu bika min hamazati shayatin wa a'udhu bika rabbi an yahdurun. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu la taqulu ra'ina maqulu unzurnaa wasma'u walilkafirina 'adhabun aleem. Surah Al-Baqara verse number 104. Itna alamata ayat. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, O you who believe, O you mu'minin, O you believers, la taqulu, don't say to the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, la taqulu raa'ina, you don't say the word raa'ina, don't use the word raa'ina when you address Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Waqulu, and you say, la taqulu, you don't say. Waqulu, qulu, you say unzurnaa. So instead of raaina, you say unzurnaa. Wasma'u, and you hear what the Prophet said. You listen to what Prophet said. Then, وَلِلْكَافِرِينَ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ وَلِلْكَافِرِينَ, and for the disbelievers, عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. عَذَاب means?
Painful.
Painful, no. Alim, painful. عَذَاب, torment. Painful, torment is there. Then, so for the disbelievers, there is painful torment. So, the Jews, when Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam addressed the people, the Jews also gathered there or came there to listen Prophet's words, to listen what the Prophet said. Then, whenever they wanted to take the attention of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they used to say raa'ina. And mu'minin, the believers also used to say raa'ina. Raa'ina means, in one meaning is that, listen, consider us, or please hear us, or consider us. Ra'ina means consider us. But it has got another meaning. Ra'ina also means the shepherd among us, or the lowest among us, the fool among us. That also is one meaning. So the Jews used this word as in the negative sense, that is the latter meaning. The Jews used this word in the latter meaning, that is, to address the Prophet, they used the word raa'ina. Raa'ina means consider us, but also it also means the fool among us, the shepherd among us, the lowest among us. So they used the word in the negative sense, but superficially they are using the word raa'ina for other people. It seemed that they just addressed the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam then. And the believers also used the same word. So, as the Jews used this word in the negative sense, Allah commanded the believers not to use the word raa'ina, and instead to use the word unzurnaa. So, unzurnaa is an unequivocal word. Unambiguous. But raa'ina has got different meaning. Okay. Then it can be used in a different sense, or it has negative meaning too. Then. Now, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. Allah addressed the Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or the believers. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. Now, we see in Tafsir Razi, اعلم أن الله تعالى خاطب المؤمنين بقوله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا في 88 موضعا من القرآن. قال ابن عباس وكان يخاطب في التوراة بقوله يا أيها المساكين, فكأنه سبحانه وتعالى لما خاطبهم أولا بالمساكين أثبت المسكنة لهم آخرا, حيث قال وضربت عليهم الذلة والمسكنة, البقرة 61. وهذا يدل على أنه تعالى لما خاطب هذه الأمة بالإيمان أولاً فإنه تعالى يؤديهم الأمانة من العذاب في النيران يوم القيامة وأيضاً فاسم المؤمن أشرف الأسماء والصفات فإذا كان يخاطبنا في الدنيا بأشرف الأسماء والصفات فنرجو من فضله أن يخاطبنا في الدنيا بأشرف الأسماء والصفات فنرجو من فضله أن يعاملنا في الآخرة بأحسن المعاملات. Then, so in tafsir Razi we see Allah addresses the believers or the Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this Ummat, Ya Ayyuhal Masakin, in 88 places, 88 places in the Holy Quran, Ya Ayyuhal Ladina Amen, or you who believe. So Allah respectfully or Allah lovingly addresses this Ummah. Then, but قال ابن عباس then ابن عباس said وكان يخاطب في التوراة بقوله يا أيها المساكين but in Torah or when Allah addresses the people of Torah the Israelites he used the word يا أيها المساكين oh you miskins oh you miskins فكأنه سبحانه وتعالى لما خاطبهم أولا بالمساكين أثبت المسكنة لهم آخرا حيث قال وضربت عليهم الذلة والمسكنة so when He addresses the Israelites as miskins. It is understood that they will be put to humiliation and misery. Adhillatu wal maskana. Humiliation and misery. As it is evident from verse 61 of Surah Al-Baqarah. Udribat alayhim adhillatu wal maskana. That verse 61. What is it?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ قلتم يا موسى لن نصبر على طعام واحد فادع لنا ربك يخرج لنا مما تنبت الأرض من بقلها وقثائها وفومها وعدسها وبصلها قال تستبدلون الذي هو أدنى بالذي هو خير اهبطوا مصرا فإن لكم ما سألتم وضربت عليهم الذلة والمسكنة وباءوا بغضب من الله ذلك بأنهم كانوا يكفرون بآيات الله ويقتلون النبيين بغير الحق ذلك بأنهم عصوا وكانوا يعتدون
Many.
And remember when you are
when you Israelites said
Oh Musa,
when Ya Musa, لن نصبر على طعام واحد. We cannot endure.
One kind of food. So invoke your Lord for us to bring forth for us of what the earth
grows.
Its herbs, its cucumber, its garlic, its lentils, and its onions.
Yes.
He said.
قال أتستبدلون الذي هو أدنى بالذي هو خير
Would you exchange that which is better for that which is lower?
Yes.
Go down anytime.
That is
Bitu Misra. And you shall find what you want.
Yes. And they were covered with وَضُرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الذِّلَّةُ وَالْمَسْكَنَةُ That is the point. And they were covered with humiliation and misery. So the Israelites were given special type of food, manna and silver, from the heaven. Then still they wanted other type of food, such as cucumber, herbs, lentil, onion, like that. So they asked Prophet Musa alayhi salam, their prophet, to pray for them, to obtain such type of foods. Instead of manna and silver, which was very nutritious and which was specially sent by Allah to the Israelites. But instead of accepting Allah's gift, they wanted an alternative. Okay. Then Musa alayhi salam asked them, would you exchange that which is better for that which is lower? So instead of manna and silver, you are asking that which is inferior in quality. Then Then if Bidu Misura, then go any town, you can get it. But this manna and salva you can't get. Except from Allah. Oh, this is specially sent for you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So go you down any town and you shall find what you want. Ihbitu Misra fa inna lakum ma sa'altum. And wallahi bad alayhim ad-dillatu wal maskana. So because of this, and they were covered with humiliation and misery. So here in this ayat, there is that Israelites were covered with humiliation and misery. Okay. So they were addressed also. They were addressed in Torah, Ya ayyuhal masakin. So wallahi alayhim ad-dillatu wal maskana. Maskana miskin. Okay. Then they were covered with humiliation and misery. And that drew on?
Drew on themselves. That was because...
themselves what? The wrath of Allah. All of them. Then, that was?
That was because they disbelieved in the proofs of Allah and killed the prophets.
Wrongfully.
That was because they used to disobedience and used to transgress.
Yes. Or the bounds. That is, they committed crimes and sins. So that's why they were put under humiliation and the misery. Then, so, but addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's ummat, this ummat, Allah addresses them, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you who believe, very lovingly. So, وَهَذَا يَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ لَمَّا خَاطَبَ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةَ بِالْإِيمَانِ أَوَّلًا فَإِنَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ يُعْطِيهِمُ الْأَمَانَ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ فِي النِّيرَانِ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Then, so, as Allah addressed this ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam relating to Iman, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, or faith, or belief, suddenly He will save them from Niran, from the hellfire, from the torment of hellfire on the day of judgment, that is يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. And as He addresses in this world, that is, in the Tafsir Ibn Kathir we see, that is, وَأَيْضًا فَاسْمُ الْمُؤْمِنِ مِنْ أَشْرَفِ الْأَسْمَاءِ وَالصِّفَاتِ فَإِذَا كَانَ يُخَاطِبُنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا بِأَشْرَفِ الْأَسْمَاءِ وَالصِّفَاتِ فَنَرْجُو مِنْ فَضْلِهِ أَنْ يُعَامِلَنَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ بِأَحْسَنِ الْمُعَامَلَاتِ. That is, as He addresses this in this world, that is, Allah addresses us, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's ummah, the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah addresses the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this world with good names and attributes. Bi ashrafil asma'i wa sifat. That is, with good names and attributes. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Very lovingly, very respectfully. Then we may expect that. We may hope that He will treat us, He will behave us in the best manner tomorrow. That is, on the day of resurrection, on the day of judgment.